Well, greetings and salutations, Series 7 test takers. This is the Series 7 Guru coming to you from my studio here in fabulous Las Vegas. The best free supplement to your paid study materials is my YouTube channel. But if you don't have a Kaplan Q Bank, I highly recommend it as a paid supplement. With my Guru10 discount code at checkout, you can get it for about $60. I also recommend the Quick Sheets as a paid supplement. That's about $20. And for that commercial, Kaplan allows me to give you a free look on their content. This is a request on QID 131-2589. We will help you with any test prep vendor question. It's just easier if it's Kaplan because I can bring it up backstage. PDQ Corporation has a 6.25 par value convertible preferred stock. Now, we shouldn't have to tell you it's $100 par value. That is the assumption unless told differently. Here they're being nice to tell you the conversion ratio. The conversion ratio is very, very important. Because on your exam, there is very high probability that you're going to have to calculate parity. And you can't calculate parity without the conversion ratio. So here they're telling you that if you'd like, you can turn this preferred stock into the issuer PDQ and get 4 shares of their common. It allows you to switch your status. The stock has an anti-dilution covenant. So dilution is the idea that if PDQ issues more stock, I need to have my convertible adjusted accordingly, right? Because I want to be able to convert into the same proportionate ownership, not, 4 shares if that doesn't give me the same proportionate ownership. So in the trust indenture, the contract between the issuer PDQ and the convertible bondholder, they're going to agree to adjust the conversion features of this bond for the issuance of new stock. That's what the anti-dilution covenant is. Covenant is the fancy word for a promise in written form found in the trust indenture. Now, PDQ declares a 10% stock dividend. Okay, so again, as a preferred convertible preferred stockholder, I want to be able to convert into 10% more too. And so now they're going to adjust the conversion ratio and the conversion price. So here we go. So if they ask me to adjust the conversion price, it would be handy to know what is that conversion price. Presently, looks like I got a typo there in my divided, but oh well. Anyways, I do that by taking par and I divide by the conversion ratio to establish the existing conversion price as being 25. Now, as I said, what I need to do is say, okay, well, I want to have the same proportionate conversion feature, right? I want to be able to convert into the same proportion of outstanding shares. And now there's 10% more shares outstanding. So I'm going to adjust my conversion ratio accordingly. So 10% times my existing 4 share conversion ratio means I'm going to want 0.4 additional shares. So I've now established my new conversion ratio for the adjustment as being 4.4 shares. So that would be my new conversion ratio. That might have been the question, or they might have asked me, what is the adjusted conversion price? By the way, I think this question is actually low probability because most of the time it's calculating parity, not can you adjust the conversion price and ratio. But the adjusted conversion ratio is 4.4. Again, that's based on par. So now we take par to get our adjusted conversion price. And when we take par divide by our new conversion ratio of 4.4, we get our adjusted conversion price of 22.73. And that is the answer to this question. So the answer is either the adjusted conversion ratio, which is 4.4, or the adjusted conversion price, which is 22.73. Again, hope you found that helpful. Remember, inch by inch, your Series 7 is a cinch. Yard by yard, your Series 7 is hard. And I'll see you for the next explication request.